Hello everyone, assalamu alaikum. Well, in this tutorial, we'll see what are futures in Flutter and how to use them. Well, first thing, futures or future is a special keyword that you need to use before function name. And well, if a function already is a future, you may need to use await and async if you call that function. While we use futures for waiting, if you want to call a function and that function, if it needs some time to get its job done and you need to wait, then you use future. That also means that at the same time, your app can do other things, not get stuck over there where a function is being called as a future. It's more like a setTimeout function in JavaScript. Well, what are the places you can use? For example, if you use network mocking, or you want to simulate network calling, or if you want to have HTTP request in your Flutter app, or another good example is shared preferences. Now here, this is a simple function and an ordinary classic function that just prints a value. The same function, we want to turn it to a future, or that will return a future. You just simply add the future keyword and then you just return the value. And over here we see that we wait 2 minutes. Okay, now you can only wait using this future keyword. If you don't have and you are going to want to wait, you can't. Okay, now let's take some real example. Well, here is my Flutter app and I just have a main function, and then I'll go ahead and create a new function and I'll call it my function. And this would just simply print a value. It could be anything, and we'll call it from here and we'll call it my function. Now we'll go ahead and run it. And we see it printed a value. Now we'll convert this function to a future function, or a function that returns future. So here we'll simply change the name my future function. Now because we are going to return a future from here, so first we have to use the future keyword. Now as we are returning, we need to use the return keyword, and then we'll use return future.delayed. And future.delayed takes a duration as a first parameter. So over here, we do duration and then seconds 2, which means we'll wait 2 seconds. And after that, we'll return a value, which is for printing. Okay. Now, this function returns a future first because we have this future keyword. And we are also returning over here a future by tagging future.delayed. All it does over here, it waits 2 seconds and then returns the value. In this case, we are just printing it. Well, once again, this future means that we are going to wait 2 seconds, okay? And after 2 seconds later, do certain thing. That's as simple as that. But this idea could be scary for beginners. Once again, whenever you see future, that means that you are going to have to wait, okay? In our case, we are waiting 2 seconds, and this could be a network mocking. Anyway, so we'll go ahead and print this function over here, and then I'll restart my app. Now see, over here, I have this function first, but this value, which is this one, gets printed later. So we could run it one more time, and we'll see the same exactly happening over here. So once again, this function, which is this one, we calling first, but this value get called later, okay? And this function is being called later, but this value is getting called first, okay? So that's happening because we are waiting. So that's interesting because Flutter doesn't have to stop the whole app and do nothing. As it waits, it can go ahead and do other thing. And this is where actually you want to use a future. You're waiting, but you don't want to stop the app. You can go ahead and do other things. Okay. Now over here, we'll create another function and we'll call it function name myData. And here we'll create a network request using http.get object. Okay. So here we'll do http.get. Now it takes URI, and that URI has to be parsed, http.parse, and inside that we'll have our network API. Now this network API, which is this one, this is a RESTful API, and this API does something. It returns things, it talks with the server, and then returns data. But as it does, it has to wait. As you want to wait, we can do other things. But now over here, if you hover over on it, you see that it says it returns the future, a function that returns the future. And if we are going to use that function, we need to tag await. So that's what we would do, await. And the caller function should also have async keyword. And with this, we'd be able to use that. Now we'll use the value, save the value in a variable called data. Okay, now after that, we want to return the data. But in our case, we're just going to return, well, data. And if you're going to return data over here, you need to use future keyword, otherwise you will have an error. Okay, so now we can go ahead and call this function. We'll call it from here. And then we'll go ahead and print the value. Now over here we do data.body, because this is a network request and this response future, and this one, it has a property called body, and body actually contains our JSON data. Now over here we see that we have an error because it wants you to use the word await. If you use the word await, you need to use the word async. Now why we are using await once again over here? Because if you use await on a function call or on a network request, that becomes a future. So now this whole thing becomes a future. As it's future, when you call a future, you have to use await. And because we are using await, we also have to use async keyword. Hopefully it makes sense. Once again, if you use await keyword when you do a network request or any kind of function call, that becomes a future, and that's why we are returning future. And when you call a future, once again, you have to use await. Okay, now let's go ahead and print a value and see what's happening. So with this, we are able to call this value from the network. Okay,
well, that's how you use future for network call. And after that, we'll see how to use future for shared preferences. And now over here, we know that shared preferences helps us to store data.
Well, if you're going to use setString to set data for our key, but now we get an error, that's because it says that setString isn't defined for type future. Now, if you hover over on it, get instance, which returns a future because we are calling a future. If you do that, you need to use await, and now the error should be gone. So whenever you use and create an instance from shared preferences, you have to use the await keyword, because shared preferences itself returns a future. It returns future meaning that you have to wait, and that's why you use the await keyword, and that's all. Okay, so if you like the video, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Thank you.